En question.
President, please be
Président,
seated.
Veuillez vous asseoir.
The court continues its hearing. Today, the chamber continues to hear the remaining testimony of Mom Soum and commence hearing testimony of witness to TCW 866. Regarding Kampong Chenang Airport Riverside, Graffy Amhoy please report the attendance of the parties and other individuals at today's proceedings.
Graffy,
Mr. President, for today's proceedings, all parties to discuss are present. Mr. Nguyen Chi is present in the holding cell downstairs. As he waived his direct presence in the courtroom, his waiver has been delivered to the greffier. The witness who is to conclude his testimony today, namely Mr. Mom Soum, is ready and present in the courtroom. We also have a reserve witness today, that is through TCW 866. And the witness confirms to his best knowledge and ability he has no relationship by blood or by law to any of the accused, that is Nguyen Chi and Khieu Somphone, or to any of the civil parties admitted in this case. The reserve witness will take an oath before the Iron Club statue this morning. President, thank you. The chamber now decides on the request by Nguyen Chi. The chamber has received a waiver from the accused Nguyen Chi, dated 29 July 2015. Which notes that due to his health, namely headache, backache, and that he cannot sit and concentrate for long, and in order to effectively participate in future hearings, he requests to waive his right to participate in and be present at the 29 July 2015 hearing. Having seen the medical report of Nguyen Chi by the duty doctor for the accused at the ECCC dated 29 July 2015, who notes that Nguyen Chi has chronic back pain when he sits for long and recommends that the chamber grant him his request so that he can follow the proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs. Based on the above information and pursuant to Rule 81.5 of the ECCC internal rules, the chamber grants Nguyen Chi his request to follow today's proceedings remotely from the holding cell downstairs via an audiovisual means. The AV unit personnel are instructed to link the proceedings to the room downstairs so that Nguyen Chi can follow it remotely. That applies for the whole day.
Cette mesure est valable toute la journée.
Before the chamber hands the floor to the parties to put further questions to the witness,
afin qu'elles interrogent le témoin,
the chamber would like to inform the parties that late yesterday afternoon the chamber received an email from the defense counsel for Nguyen Chi with the attached document of list of the 66 DCCAM documents that were requested by OCP to be part of the case file
que le bureau des coprocureurs avait demandé à verser au dossier.
The chamber would like now to
la chambre souhaite à présent
put question to the co-prosecutors regarding the 66 documents in the attachment by the defense counsel and as requested by the defense team yesterday, is the information correct? And what about the translation of those DCCAM documents? And the chamber will seek clarification from the co-prosecutor, and you may proceed, the deputy co-prosecutor.
Good morning, Mr. President, and thank you. So a few points about these documents. First of all, we don't intend to rely on all 66 of the documents that were listed in the DCCAM summary. 55 of those documents were on the OCP's Rule 80, Subrule 3 document list prior to the beginning of trial. That list was filed in June of 2014. So all of these documents have been available to the trial chamber and the parties for more than a year. That filing was E305/13. At the time that that document list was filed, the documents were not put on Xylab, they were put in a shared folder. If your honors look at paragraph 5 of E305/13, you'll see a reference to the shared document folder where all of the documents were placed. So again, trial chamber and all of the parties have had access to the documents for more than a year. The specific annex that the documents are listed in is Annex C2. The document number of Annex C2 is E305/13.23. And that annex, in addition to listing the documents, also contains a short summary of the contents and lists the points of the indictment that each document is relevant to. So not only have the documents been available since June of 2014, the parties have all been on notice, at least in general terms, of the contents of the documents and that they relate to Trappes-Haute-Mort Dam. Now our calculation is that of the 55 documents, the 55 DCCAM statements that are part of that annex, and I should also indicate that that annex has been fully translated into French, and so the relevance of all these statements to Trappes-Haute-Mort has also been available to anyone working in French. Our calculation is that of the 55 documents, 25 have been translated into English so far. I don't believe any of them have been translated into French yet. So as far as translation goes, you know, I wasn't here during the last trial, but my understanding was the position is obviously that there's more material than can be immediately translated by ITU, and the chamber's guidance was that each party is to prioritize for translation the documents that they wish to rely on an ongoing basis. That's a process that OCP is engaged in, with the understanding that anything that's not translated by the end of the case will not be considered properly put before the chamber and will not be relied on by the chamber. So we're aware of that, and we understand that it's our obligation to translate anything that we wish to rely on and that we wish to have before the chamber at the end of the case. Now, in terms of notice, we submit that there's no issue with notice. The documents have been available for more than a year. The relevance to this trial segment has been available to the parties for more than a year. Obviously, both defense teams have national lawyers who work in Khmer. They can read the documents, and it's also open to them to apply for translation for any documents they wish to use in a witness examination. Even for untranslated documents, obviously, Questions can be asked in Khmer using a Khmer document to a Khmer-speaking witness. I think those are all of my comments at the moment, unless the chamber has more questions.
Oui, merci, Monsieur le Président. Quelques questions de suivi. Vous nous avez fait mention, Monsieur le Procureur, de 55 documents qui figuraient sur une liste et qui étaient donc accessibles à toutes les parties depuis juin 2014.
Have been accessible to all parties since
ces documents sont également partie de ceux qui ont été déclarés recevables par la Chambre dans sa décision, je crois que c'est sur la recevabilité des documents, la décision E305/17 qui contient, elle, un certain nombre d'annexes indiquant quels sont les documents qu'elle considère recevables et quelles sont les objections des parties qu'elle a pu retenir. Donc ce serait important pour nous de savoir si ces documents sont effectivement les documents déjà versés au dossier étant considérés comme recevables ou si simplement ce sont des documents qui ont été mis à la disposition des parties.
Documents merely that have
la
been
deuxième
made available
chose, vous nous avez dit qu'effectivement les parties étaient responsables de garantir la traduction en temps utile des documents versés au débat. Il est vrai qu'aujourd'hui nous sommes en train de discuter des questions relatives au site de Trapinkma.
Now today we are also talking about Trapinkma, and I do
alors, j'avais noté que sur les 66 déclarations qui ont été résumées dans le DCCAM dans son document E353.1, il y en avait en réalité 18 qui n'étaient pas dans le dossier. Sauf erreur de ma part, donc je suppose que ces 18-là sont 18 déclarations que vous n'entendez pas utiliser.
So do I take it that those 18 are statements that you don't intend to use?
Que sur if that is not the case, please le restant des déclarations, il y en avait 13.
From the remainder of the statements, there are perhaps.
C'est mes calculs, peut-être que je me trompe. 13
again,
à la fois en anglais et en Khmer.
That are available both in English and in Khmer.
38 and there are 38 that mais qui ne seraient disponibles qu'en Khmer.
But which are
voilà, donc ce qui intéresse véritablement la Chambre, c'est de savoir
so the chamber is
si vous pouvez
really
dire quand ces déclarations, quand ces documents sont susceptibles d'être disponibles en anglais. J'entends bien que toutes les équipes de défense et toutes les parties disposent de la capacité, disposent de composantes nationales cambodgiennes qui peut lire ces documents, mais néanmoins, il est important que la partie internationale puisse aussi avoir accès à ces documents. Donc, nous souhaiterions avoir ces informations. Je ne sais pas s'il est possible pour vous de nous les procurer aujourd'hui. Si ce n'est pas le cas, peut-être pourriez-vous faire le point après la pause du déjeuner.
But if that's not the case, perhaps after our lunch break, you could update us on all of that. Thank you.
Yeah, it might perhaps be better for me to research it a bit further over lunch. I can say that those statements that are on the defense's list that were not included in our original document list are things that we don't intend to rely on. Those are things that we haven't asked to be part of the case file. Those are things that we've made a decision that we're not interested in. Now, in terms of things that have been translated into Khmer in English, or things that are only available in Khmer, it's my understanding that we're in the process of prioritizing everything, and we need to decide exactly what it is that we want to have on the case file at the end of the case. But let me do more research over lunch and try to give you a more precise answers about this.
President, thank you. And Councillor Antaguse, you have the floor. La parole est à Maître Antaguise.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président.
Thank
bonjour.
Il
convient que je fasse une petite précision quand même, parce que je ne peux pas laisser dire à l'accusation que, en juin 2014, nous étions notifiés de ces documents comme si nous n'avions pas fait notre travail. Je rappelle que dans nos exceptions d'irrecevabilité portant sur certains documents proposés pour le procès 02-2, document E327-3, nous avions indiqué au paragraphe 17 de ces écritures que la Chambre a rappelé aux parties leur devoir de s'assurer que les documents proposés soient disponibles en temps utile dans les trois langues des CETC. Ça, nous l'avions dit et nous avions expliqué que nous faisions un certain nombre d'exceptions de recevabilité sur des documents et que les documents qui font aujourd'hui l'objet de discussion n'étaient pas traduits et que nous n'avions donc pas pu en prendre connaissance proprement et faire des objections sur ce point-là. Donc, dès ces écritures de février 2015, nous avions indiqué que nous avions un problème avec ces documents-là. Et c'est la note de bas de page numéro 5 de ces mêmes écritures. Donc, il a été mentionné à un moment qu'il y avait une difficulté de traduction et une difficulté même pour nous de faire nos observations quant à la recevabilité de ces documents. C'est dire que nous avons été surpris lorsque nous avons reçu la décision de la Chambre acceptant ces documents, puisque nous n'avions pas pu faire nos observations en tant qu'utile, puisque les documents n'étaient disponibles qu'en Khmer. Donc, la difficulté que nous avons aujourd'hui, c'est que nous avons des documents qui ont déjà des numéros E3, donc il me semble que dans le cadre de la procédure devant la Chambre, avoir un numéro 3, c'est considérer que ces documents qui ont été produits devant la Chambre, sauf que une partie, la majeure partie de la composante de défense de notre équipe n'a pas le contenu de ces déclarations qui sont considérées comme déjà produites devant la Chambre, parce que certaines ne sont disponibles qu'en Khmer. Alors oui, j'entends bien que nous avons des composantes Khmer au sein de nos équipes, mais lorsqu'on sait l'épaisseur des déclarations de DCCAM, lorsqu'on sait la charge de travail et lorsqu'on sait aussi, peut-être petit rappel, que toute la deuxième partie 2014, nous étions monopolisés par l'appel, on ne va pas monopoliser le peu de ressources que nous avons pour faire un travail de traduction qui n'est pas, a priori, dans les attributions du personnel juridique qui fait un travail juridique ou d'analyse de la preuve pour un problème de traduction qui, soit dit en passant, et du ressort des personnes qui veulent produire ces éléments en preuve. Donc, je tiens pour résumer à rappeler que dans ces écritures E327-3, nous avions soulevé le problème des traductions qui n'étaient pas faites. La Chambre a néanmoins admis des déclarations qui n'étaient qu'en une seule langue, mais nous avions déjà indiqué que nous ne pouvions pas nous prononcer même sur la recevabilité de ces documents parce qu'ils n'étaient qu'en une seule langue. Donc là, aujourd'hui, on a ce problème de déclarations qui ont déjà des numéros 3, qui sont donc susceptibles d'être utilisé par n'importe quelle partie, sauf que il y a des déclarations importantes qui ne sont pas traduites. Et je rappelle que c'est à la partie qui a demandé, qui a fait figurer ces déclarations sur les listes, de s'occuper des traductions. Donc, qu'on ne veuille pas nous dire, ça a été notifié en juin 2014 et vous n'avez pas fait votre travail. Non, nous avons indiqué dans des écritures qu'il y avait un problème de traduction. Il fallait s'en occuper à ce moment-là.
Voilà.
President, thank you for the observations made by the concerned parties on this matter. The Chamber now hands the floor to the defense team to put questions to the witness. First, to the defense team for Nunji and counsel, you may proceed.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, Council. Good morning, Mr. Witness. I have a few questions that I would like to ask you, some follow-up questions I would like to start with. Yesterday, you were asked a question by the International Co-Prosecutor about arrest of three members of your unit. Yesterday, I believe, but also in your statement, you said that these arrests were made secretly. Can you explain to the trial chamber how you came to find out about these arrests while they were being secret at the same time? Can you expand a little bit on that, please?
Comment se fait-il que vous en ayez eu vent, que vous ayez appris qu'il y a eu des arrestations?
When they came to make an arrest, they did not inform anyone, either the group or not the unit.
Ni le groupe, ni
and that's why I said that it was a secretive matter.
C'était une question secrète.
I understand now. But then my question to you is also the
Mais
following.
Alors,
you said yesterday that you were, quote unquote, horrified of the arrest because there was no justification for the arrest. Now, if people weren't told the reason for the arrest, how at the same time could you then be horrified because there was no justification?
Horrifié qu'il n'y ait pas de justification. Permettez que j'explique.
I was fearful because of what happened, that is, because of the arrest. And I was afraid that I might have acted wrongly and that I would be arrested.
That I understand,
oui,
Mr. Witness.
But
you were at the time not in the position to say whether there was a justification for these arrests, yes or no. Is that correct?
Était fondée ou s'il y avait une justification, un motif à cette arrestation.
Sector unit, everyone minded his or her own business. Even if sometimes we knew something or we heard of something, but we kept it to ourselves. It would be risky to say anything to anyone, and usually we adhere to the principle in Khmer, which we say is to grow a kapok tree, that is to keep our mouths shut.
I understand, Mr. Witness. But is it then for me fair to say that because you didn't know the reason for the arrest, your statement yesterday that there was no justification for it is speculation on your side?
Le fait que vous ayez dit hier qu'il n'y avait pas de justification à cette arrestation était une hypothèse émise par vous-même.
That was my personal thought.
Réponse. C'est ce que
because
j'ai pensé.
They arrested people.
Parce qu'ils arrêtaient des gens.
And I did not know the reason for the arrest. So I myself, I had to be very careful with my actions.
À ce que je faisais.
I was fearful of doing anything wrong and that
je
I would be
de
arrested.
une erreur et ensuite d'être arrêté.
Let me move on to something that you said yesterday about the working hours while you were at the dam work site. You said there were three shifts per day and that the morning shift would start, if I say that correctly, 6 o'clock in the morning. The day before yesterday, there was a another witness testifying in relation to the dam work site, and he said that workers at the dam started working when, quote unquote, it was clear enough to see other workers. Is that statement of his accurate? And does that confirm that working time is, in your memory, was 6 o'clock from 6 till 11 in the morning?
Les horaires de travail qui, d'après vos souvenirs, étaient de 6 heures jusqu'à 11 heures le matin?
Allow me to reiterate the point.
The
working hours varied.
Les horaires de travail dépendaient.
We started early when the situation was demanding. However, the regular hours for the morning shift were 6 to 11, and for the afternoon was 2 to 5. And when the situation was demanding, for example, we would work non-stop from 6 o'clock in the morning until 9 at night.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. I would like to move on to another topic, and that's relating to some people that you discussed yesterday and also in your statement to the investigators of the investigating judge. Yesterday, you spoke briefly about Tan Nau, and that he was, as you said yesterday, in the circle of Taval. What do you mean, what did you mean when you said that Tanau was in the circle of Taval?
Tanau faisait partie du cercle de Taval.
I already confirmed the point yesterday.
Daniel's group
was the one who has the supervisory role
above us, and Daniel
was in charge of the mobile units, belongs to the sector under the supervision of Taval.
I understand, maybe it's a translation issue, but I was intrigued by the words that you used, in the circle of Taval. That's something possibly different than under the supervision. What do you mean
when you said in the circle of Taval? Lorsque vous avez utilisé le terme dans le cercle de Taval, que vouliez-vous dire?
Answer. I do not know how to respond.
Je ne sais pas comment répondre.
In the circle means that within the unit there were groups and subgroups. So the chiefs of units were in charge of groups, and the chief of groups were responsible for subgroups.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Witness. Yesterday you also described Taval as the overall leader. What exactly do you mean, or did you mean, with the words overall leader?
Par là, lorsque vous avez utilisé le terme grand chef.
Answer. He was in charge of the Pyeong Thamo work site from places to places, so he had an overall supervisory role at that site.
c'était le surveillant en chef de ce site.
About the demeanor of Daval. What kind of leader was he?
Et comment était-il, Daval?
Gentle person or was he a harsh person?
Was he
how did he express himself?
Can you give us some details about Daval? Comment était-il? Comment s'exprimait-il? Pouvez-vous nous en parler?
Answer. Allow me to réponse. Tell the court. I was not with him constantly. I was living and working in a different group.
He was in a different place.
Whether he was violent or not, I have no idea. But there was no issues in my group or unit.
Au sein de notre de mon groupe de mon unité, nous n'avons pas eu de problème.
Mr. Witness, I would like to read an excerpt from a statement of another person who worked at the dam, a statement that he gave to DC Chem, a statement about Daval, and after having read that excerpt, I would like to ask your reaction.
Objection, Mr. President.
Accusation. Objection, Monsieur.
Your Honor, the Chamber's ruling yesterday, as I understood it, was that witnesses were not to be led on the contents of statements, and that's what counsel is trying to do now.
On ne doit pas orienter les témoins en se servant du
contexte
de déclaration faite. Et c'est ce que l'avocat.
Although it's not a common law court we're cross-examining, but having letting that aside, I properly introduced Daval. I asked him questions about Daval, and now I would like to read an excerpt from another witness that says something. Who says something about Daval?
And
after having exhausted open questions, I can now, at this point in time, ask him a question about this particular excerpt.
Une question concernant cet extrait.
President.
Le président.
The objection is overruled.
L'objection est rejetée.
You may now proceed, Mr.
Allez-y,
counsel.
Mr.
Witness, if you
Monsieur
get the question, please give your response. But I
si
remember
question,
that the question has not been yet put to the witness.
Mais la question n'a
I
pas
am
encore
right.
Été, posée au témoin.
Thank you, Mr. President.
So,
Mr. Witness, I will be reading a very short excerpt from this statement, and then I will ask
de cette
your reaction.
Et ensuite je vous demanderai de réagir.
Question, how about Tamong and Daval,
question,
did they ever reprimand you?
Daval, vous ont-ils reprimandé?
And then this person answers as follows.
La réponse de cette
I rarely met
la
them
suivante.
Because I was at regiment
je
level lower than theirs. But these people were very good at reprimanding others because they were very unkind and ruthless men. They were much tougher than Yi Chim. I heard that people always called him the golden fanged man. Question, who was called that name?
Question,
that was Daval.
Qui?
He never spoke clear words and we did not know what he was saying sometimes. He always responded using the words ba-ba, the slang, ba-ba, and never clearly articulated the word bat. Yes,
Khmer.
Not sure if I pronounce it properly in Khmer, Mr. Witness. But having read to you these two excerpts on Daval, can you give us your reaction, please?
Quelle est votre réaction?
Answer. I have
réponse.
Told the court already.
Je l'ai déjà indiqué
I
la
did
chambre.
Not pose any trouble within my group. I do not know whether he
je
was harsh or not.
Ne connaissais pas Taval.
Somebody said they
j'ignore
used
si
to meet with Daval. Perhaps that individual knew the demeanor of Daval. And as for me, I have no idea.
plus de détails sur son comportement.
Very well, Mr. Bridges, thank you.
Question. Merci.
At one point in time, Daval was arrested. Do you recall
Daval a par la suite été arrêté.
When Daval disappeared, when he was arrested?
Rappelez-vous à quel moment Daval a disparu? À quel moment a-t-il été arrêté?
Answer. Concerning his arrest, I do not know when he was arrested. I knew that he disappeared. That is what I know. And as for the dates of the disappearance or arrest,
it's
not known by me. He disappeared in 1977. I do not know the exact date or month. I was not among the high-ranking people, so I did not know.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Yesterday, you testified that you were working at the dam site almost the entire period of 1977. It seems that Daval was arrested on the 28th of June 1977. So that would mean halfway in the period that you were working at the dam. Does that somehow jog your memory that
in
midterm of the period that you were working, Daval was arrested, June 77? Does that ring a bell?
Qu'il ait été arrêté en juin 1977, à peu près au milieu de la période où vous y travailliez. Cela vous rappelle quelque chose?
Answer.
Réponse.
What I know is that Daval was arrested in 1977. I do not know about the date he was arrested. There was no announcement when the arrest was made against Daval, or there was no meeting at all concerning the arrest of Daval.
I understand. But are you able, I realize that's a difficult question, but are you able to make a distinction in terms of working conditions, etc., between the periods before June 77 and the period after June 77, or is that difficult?
À votre avis, y avait-il une différence dans ces conditions de travail avant et après le milieu de l'année 1977, ou est-ce que c'est trop difficile pour vous de l'évaluer?
Answer. On this point, working conditions were not different too much in nature.
We had elles ne différaient pas beaucoup.
Similar or the same working conditions.
Nous avions des conditions de
and
travail à peu près
likewise,
similaires.
Food was quite the same.
Et il en allait de même pour la nourriture.
Do you recall at the time when Daval was arrested?
Lorsque Daval
that
a été
workers
arrêté,
were talking among each other as to the possible reasons for his arrest.
Vous rappelez si des travailleurs,
was anything communicated as to why Daval was arrested? Do you remember anything about information being given to you or maybe your fellow mobile unit members? Do you recall anything?
De votre unité itinérante, aurait appris quoi que ce soit à ce sujet? Est-ce que vous vous rappelez de quelque chose?
Answer.
Réponse.
Rumor was from one and other saying that Daval was arrested.
Rumeurs,
I do not know whether Daval betrayed the regime. He had been arrested. Everyone knew about that. And we heard about the arrest from one another. He disappeared and everyone started to question each other where Daval was.
tout le monde s'interrogeait là-dessus et s'est demandé où il était. Certains disaient qu'il était allé suivre des séances d'études, d'autres disaient qu'il avait été arrêté.
Small group, so
moi, j'étais membre d'un petit groupe.
Do not know fully what happened
et donc,
to him.
Je n'avais pas toutes les informations sur ce qui lui est arrivé. Question. Rappelez-vous si à l'époque,
people talked about the hiding of rice in secret places, rice that was meant to feed the villagers and the workers. Did you hear anything about that as a possible reason for Taval's arrest?
Est-ce que vous avez entendu ce genre de choses comme motif de l'arrestation de Taval?
Answer. I do not have the full grasp of the situation.
Je ne comprenais pas très bien la situation.
Within a mobile unit, we could not move freely.
Au sein d'une unité itinérante,
after we receive the assignment, we would go to the exact location to work, and as I said, we could not move freely.
Sur un lieu précis pour travailler.
Did you hear at the time anything about fighting between various military forces in 1977?
Forces
from on the one hand the southwest zone and forces on the other hand from the northwest zone. Did you ever hear anything about that at the time?
Et celle de la zone du nord-ouest de l'autre côté. En avez-vous entendu parler à l'époque?
Answer, I have never heard of
réponse, je n'en ai jamais entendu parler.
Mr. Witness, I would like
question.
To read an excerpt
bien,
from that same statement that I just read an excerpt from earlier. Mr. President, that is E3/8991 document, ERN number 0096994, and Khmer page 0073032.
President, please repeat. ER numbers, there was no translation a while ago.
Yes, of course, Mr. President. English ERN 0096994 and Khmer ERN 0073032. The question to this person, that same person is as follows. The purge became intensive in 1978, right? Yes, but according to my knowledge, it was much slower in 1977 and took place only at mobile unit level. Question, did these people work in the same place? Answer, yes, they worked in the same place, but they were in different groups. If any members of one group went too far away from their base, they would be arrested by their rivals. I once saw Tanim's forces cross a remote field. But if anyone of this group went too far away from their group, they would be arrested right away by the other ones. I knew this because one day I was in the field hunting for eels, and I met those forces of Tanim's, who were also hunting for eels in the field. I chatted with them, and I noticed that they had weapons in their hands. They hunted for their rivals too. These people killed each other, and I was not sure of how they became traitorous against each other. It depended on who did the arrests and killings first. And if you managed to do it before anyone else, you would be the winner. But the people from the southwest zone were able to do so first. They came in numbers and first made arrest of Tanim and his subordinates, and later on everyone else associated with them. So, Mr. Witness, this is that same person speaking earlier about Taval. And he is talking about clashes
de Taval et qui parle de conflits
forces from Tanim
entre les forces
and with forces from the southwest zone.
Et les forces de la zone sud-ouest.
Considering the likelihood that Taval was part of Tanim's forces,
Taval faisait probablement partie des forces de Tanim.
Do you recall anything of such clashes? People talking about fighting?
Objection, Mr. President. I waited until counsel had read the excerpt because I wanted to get a full picture of the question. But what happened is he asked the witness, did you ever hear anything about fighting between the southwest zone and the northwest zone? The witness said no. He then read a long excerpt that amounts to an argument, made an assumption that Taval was part of some hypothetical force of Tanim, and then repeated exactly the same question to the witness, which was, did you ever hear about any conflict between northwest zone and southwest zone? So it's asked and answered with a lengthy, and we would submit unnecessary reading of a statement in between.
I agree that the part on Taval was an argument, so I'm happy to withdraw that part of the question and formulate the question more neutrally to the witness. And the question now would be, having heard this excerpt, Mr. Witness, clashes between Tanim's forces and southwest zone forces, does that ring a bell?
Co-prosecutor, Mr. President, I would like to put an objection to the question. It is a repetitive one.
And
the witness said he did not know what happened between the forces of the two zones.
That's correct. That's why I now confront him with an excerpt from somebody else and ask him whether that somehow refreshes his memory.
I think
that is a practice. Which is well allowed.
Tout à fait acceptable.
Le président. The objection by the co-prosecutor, the national co-prosecutor, is granted. It is a proper objection put by national deputy co-prosecutor. Mr. Witness, please do not give the response to the repetitive question. Mr.
Copé,
you may now resume your line of questioning.
Copé, vous pouvez reprendre vos questions.
I'm not sure if I understand,
Maître
Mr. President.
This was the first time I asked him a question about
this statement. However, I will move on.
Le président.
President, I explained party already in response to your request yesterday. Parties are required to put open questions first.
Poser d'abord des questions ouvertes.
And after such questions, et to refresh the witness memory,
s'il y a lieu you de rafraîchir can, parties la mémoire are du allowed témoin, to take some portion
to ask the witness. As for the last question put by you, you
témoin.
Received the response from a witness already that
posée,
he did not
vous
know
a déjà répondu.
About that. And you started to quote a statement from another witness to put to this witness. As I said, the objection by the national co-prosecutor is correct. The question is a repetitive one because the witness gave already clear response.
Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, I will move on. Yesterday, you also spoke about somebody called Tachil. You spoke about him in terms of someone who chaired a conference. What else do you recall about Tachil?
Qu'est-ce que vous vous rappelez concernant ce Tachil?
Answer. I told the court already.
Je l'ai déjà indiqué à la chambre.
I was in a mobile unit. And during the
big
meeting or conference, I was required to attend the conference.
Je devais y
Tachil chaired the conference.
Tachil
I, this is what I knew, and as for other things else, I do not know.
Je savais, je n'en sais rien d'autre.
And I knew Tachil, and Tachil was in the conference.
Tachil,
he chaired the conference.
À cette conférence, il l'a présidé.
Do you know to whom he was related?
Savez-vous avec qui il avait des liens de parenté?
Dante. Answer. I do not know.
Je l'ignore.
Do you recall? It's a long time ago, I understand, Mr. Witness, but do you recall any topics that he discussed during the conference?
Dont il a parlé pendant cette conférence.
Non. Answer.
Réponse.
During the Democratic Cambodia, the Leap of Forward slogan was a very important for the regime. Everyone was required to work as quickly as possible, so everything has to comply with that slogan. And the announcement, this slogan was regularly announced. I do not know what else I can explain.
C'est pas quoi vous dire d'autre.
At that time, the slogan
à cette époque,
was long live or live forward the regime.
Il y avait ce slogan concernant le grand bord en avant du régime.
Mr. Witness, this Tachil spoke on the 15th of March 1978. Or maybe one or two days before, to a delegation of Yugoslavian journalists. Mr. President, that is E3/1113. English ERN 00434864, French 00623009, and Khmer 1080. He answered questions from these Yugoslavian journalists about topics like food, marriage, what was generally done at the dam site with people who were lazy. So his questions, the questions from the Yugoslavian journalists are specifically related to the dam.
Posé par les journalistes yougoslaves,
asked a question about food, he said, and I quote as follows, food would include beef, pork, fish, fish paste, prahok. Is that answer that he gave to the journalist a correct one? Is that corresponding with your recollection that people were given beef, pork, fish, and prahok?
Il y avait donc du bœuf, du porc, du poisson et du prahok.
Answer: we were given such a meal once in a while, for example, during the conference, and after big events such as conferences, we were not given such a meal or dishes.
En dehors de ces conférences, de ces grands événements, on
he also said, and I quote as follows, there is a three-day break per month, and one morning or 1 or 2 hours are spent for education. Question, if there are bad or lazy people in the work site, what do you do with these people? He says, the issues are rare. However, if such a case happens, the person will be trained with politics and consciousness.
Ce cas est rare, s'il existe, on résout le problème de façon politique et
the answer, Mr. Witness, that he gave to these journalists, does that correspond with your own experience?
Correspond-elle avec votre propre expérience?
Non, je ne suis pas. Answer.
Réponse.
I am not able to give you the explanation.
Je ne it suis pas broad en to mesure say de that vous l'expliquer.
It depended on the chiefs
cela
of the work site or units. Some chiefs were flexible, so I cannot say, cannot explain you on this matter.
Very well. He was also asked questions, Mr. Witness, about marriage, all kinds of questions. And he replied to the journalist as follows. The mobile unit members are allowed to get married if a proposal for marriage is made. The mobile unit commanding committee or the cooperative decides to arrange the marriage. If anyone is married, they can go to live with their spouse. He or she is allowed to write home, and a messenger is used to collect and or deliver the letters from one place to another.
Chez lui et it's not les messagers difficult, yeah. Peuvent transporter les messages. Ce n'est pas difficile.
Yesterday you spoke at the end of your testimony about
hier,
marriage.
Vous avez parlé du mariage.
What Tachil said to these Yugoslavian journalists, is that corresponding with
est-ce que cette
your memory?
Donnée par Tachil aux journalistes yougoslaves correspond à vos souvenirs?
Answer. I said already yesterday, marriage was held by Anka at the work site. There was a wedding in different places. Some marriages were forced, but some were voluntary.
Certains mariages étaient forcés, d'autres étaient volontaires.
I mean, if the marriage was voluntarily held, the men and women love each other, and they were able to have each other as husband and wife. And I told the court already, the marriage or wedding was held at the work site after the marriage, because it was so dark at night, the newlywed did not know even who their husband and wife were. The wedding was not beautifully decorated at that time, only leaves or rice stalk was used to decorate the venue. It was not the same as the present time.
Ce n'était pas comme aujourd'hui.
Some women were not loved by men, so there were some issues after the marriage.
Certaines femmes n'étaient pas aimées par leur mari, et il pouvait y avoir des problèmes après le mariage.
President, please wait a little bit, Mr. Copé. You may not proceed, Judge Lavagne.
Monsieur Copé, juge Lavagne, vous avez la parole, dit le président.
Juste à titre d'information, pour que ça soit noté aussi au transcript, je précise que le document E3-1113 auquel Maître Copé fait référence est en réalité un télégramme qui a été envoyé au bureau 870 et qui est le compte-rendu de la visite par les journalistes yougoslaves. Et ce télégramme a été adressé en copie à Oncle Noon, Bangwon, Bangwan, au bureau et aux archives. Voilà, juste à titre de précision.
Just for information.
Indeed, it was, Judge Lavergne.
And then, to be complete,
there is also document E3/2670, which is a document with ERN 00525831 in English, 00389204 in French, and 00555723 in Khmer.
President, please repeat the identity of the document. There was no interpretation a while ago. There was no interpretation in Khmer.
Yes, Mr. President. E3/2670. It's a dispatch note from the Embassy of France in Yugoslavia to the Minister of Foreign Affairs. And it's relating the same interview from the Yugoslavian journalist, in which almost an identical version of the content of that interview is being provided. Just to be complete. Mr. President, I'm mindful of the clock. I still have a few questions
Monsieur
on marriage. Thank you. Yesterday you spoke about the women who were marrying,
Monsieur
that they didn't know their husbands, that they didn't love their husbands. Did you know any of those married couples? Did you know any of them personally? And if yes, can you give us a name?
Et si oui, êtes-vous en mesure de nous donner des noms? Réponse.
No,
non.
I don't. It happened a long time ago.
And
I do not remember them all.
Je ne me souviens pas de tous.
But do you remember if any of those couples, persons within that couples,
si
spoke to you and told you
vous ont parlé, et vous ont dit
clearly
clairement,
that they didn't like to marry this person? Did you speak to any of them about their marriage at the time?
Épouser telle ou telle personne? Avez-vous évoqué leur mariage avec elle à cette époque-là?
Voilà.
I knew about that it's because those married people were asked to provide their impression. That's the word they use at the time. They don't use the word marriage at the time. And some of them said that they got confused with their spouses because of the so many men and women who were married at the time. And I didn't attend the marriage ceremony itself, but I was told by the men who got married at the time. And after the ceremony was completed, some of them could not find their wives. And before they got married, they did not, most of them did not know one another at all. So I cannot tell you any more specific than what I have just stated.
But did any of those men tell you specifically, I did...
Et ces hommes vous ont-ils dit spécifiquement, Président?
President, please hold on. And Judge Lavange, you may proceed.
Oui, je suis désolé de vous interrompre, Maître Copé, mais je viens de vérifier l'information que vous avez donnée, à savoir que le document E3-2670 viendrait confirmer le contenu du document E3-11-13. Or, le document E3-2670 concerne des informations relatives à la frontière vietnamienne. Il n'y a absolument aucun rapport avec le Trapinthma.
I don't know what's in the French.
Maître Copeau, je ne sais pas ce qui figure dans la version française.
French ERN is...
L'ERN en français est
00389204 and the E3 is 2670.
Pouvez-vous juste tourner la page et il y a le titre qui
Could
figure sur la
page suivante. And then you'll see the title on the following page.
No, it's an embassy of France in Yugoslavia, Belgrade, 31st of March, 78. And then on page 7, on the dams among the brigadiers. And following pages are all about the dam, and it's written by Dragoslav Rancic on the 25th of March. And it's... As of French ERN 00389208, English 00525837, and Khmer 00555728, it starts in English on the dams among the brigadiers, and then it speaks about the Trapinthma Dam.
Le barrage de Trapinthma.
Je vais vérifier pour le possible qu'il y ait deux références pour ce même document.
Let me check. There may be two references for the same document.
I'm not sure, Mr. Witness, if you recall my question.
Maître Copeau, je ne sais pas, citez-moi si vous vous souvenez de ma
I think
question.
I asked you.
J'espère que oui. Je vous ai demandé.
If you recall any of those men specifically telling you, I did not want to marry that woman that I just married. Do you recall any such conversation?
Vous souvenez-vous d'une telle conversation?
No, no such thing happened.
Réponse non.
And as I have stated,
il n'y a pas eu de telle conversation. Men
and women who were married were faithful to one another.
Les hommes et les femmes qui étaient mariés
However, in certain cases, they did not love one another at all, and for that reason, you can say they were forced to get married. Usually, marriage should be consensual.
Forcer le mariage en
However,
normal,
there was one case at the Bentmore Dam, that is the case of a married couple,
that
they didn't consummate their marriage. They argued all night, and that highlights the fact that they did not agree with one another to get married.
Qu'ils ne s'entendaient pas et qu'ils n'étaient pas d'accord pour se marier l'un à l'autre.
And that's what I learned that they did not agree with one another.
My last question, Mr. President.
D'accord, qu'ils ne s'entendaient pas.
Did you ever encounter any of those couples after 1979?
Après
1979. And if yes, do you know whether any of those couples had filed for a divorce?
Ont par la suite demandé un divorce?
Some of them remained as husbands and wives.
Certains couples sont restés ensemble,
as
mari et
I later on met them. However, others got divorced.
And
not every couple remains together since.
Les couples ne sont pas tous restés ensemble depuis.
That's what I can say. Some remained as husband and wives, while others got divorced.
And then a very last follow-up question. I apologize, Mr. President. Did they tell you, Mr. Witness, the reason for their divorce?
Vous ont-ils dit pourquoi ils avaient divorcé?
I cannot tell you that.
Je ne saurais vous le dire.
I cannot tell you about their thinking, so nothing I can tell you.
Donc je ne peux pas vous répondre.
And at that time, of course, it seems that they got married, but I could not tell you what went behind the scene.
Thank you very much, Mr. Witness. Thank you, Mr. President.
Je vous remercie. J'en ai terminé, Monsieur le Président.
President, thank you, Council. It is now appropriate for a short break. We will take a break now and resume at 10:30. Court officer, please assist the witness during the break at the waiting room for civil parties and witnesses and have him return to the courtroom at 10:30. The court is now in recess.